In this STEM, you can see the kind of a population of the youth. This is a 2014 statistics. Now you can understand it are definitely multifolded. Around 6 crore population of youth who are already into the educational aspect of it. Then, what does it mean in the youths in school? Again, the 2015-16. When I say the youth, it's from 15 to 29. That's the age group that we are talking about. So this is the number that you are looking at in school also. And again, which comes to higher education. So put together, you have around 20 crore children who are already into the education system, right, from 15 to 29. You all know that till 18, they are called as child. Okay, that's sometimes it surprises many of you, like, till 18, they are called as child, like 17 years and 364 days to be precise. So if that is the case, the student who is studying in college first year is still a child. And we don't know like how you are going to treat him. We still treat him as a 2 year, 3 year old kid. Even college has changed. I'm seeing most of the college which has girls this side, boys this side. Then I don't know why you have a co-ed education then. It's again, a lot of things are oxymoron, okay? This is where the conflict comes in. If that is the case, now I'm looking at from the HR perspective. Today we all know that whether we like it or not, we are moving into the chronic capitalism. So that's the order of the day. Kind of the government policies which has been insisting and the changes that we are bringing. India is more of an SME, but I'm sure like within another 10 years of time, SME will vanish from this country if this trend is going on. That's dangerous for our future employability aspect. When you talk about employability, it doesn't start with the higher education. It never starts with the higher education. Certain skills have to start from much younger, like when these people talk about creativity or collaboration, whatever you talk about, the four C's of 21st century skill, it all has to start from much an younger age. This is what a lot of alternative schools are doing. But in India, when you talk about an alternative school and the structure that they follow, still the parents haven't understood what they are up to. In our school, like, we see to that agriculture is a compulsory component, and every day, 2 hours of agriculture for a student is a must. It's very important because in through agriculture, you can teach every skill. Through agriculture, all your science, physics, geography, history, humanities, whatever it has been said, it is there in agriculture. Art is one form which is very essential for all students. Today, David Kelly from the Stanford University in 1990, he started a program called Design Thinking. Design thinking is going to be the future of education. UK, US, they've already tested this. Design thinking, the concept of design thinking. Today, it has been only to the elite that this design thinking has been given. If you go to an NID, National Institute of Design, or IIT Mumbai, or like Man said, University, Anna University, they might be talking about this design thinking. The design thinking need to be taken very seriously. So those people who are interested in school education and higher education, please spend some time on what David Kelly is talking on the concept of design thinking. Now, these are the four skills which I would recommend from the HR point, purely from the HR point, where Oxford Economics, every 5 years they will roll out what is then important for the next century for the youth to really acquire. So these are the four skills they are talking about. One is digital skill, agile thinking, interpersonal and communication, and global operating skill. Now, where does, in a country like India, where children are not even allowed to go for an excursion. To go for an excursion, you have to take a permission from the CEO, and the CEO will say, why the hell you wanted to go, because something will happen there. If that is the case, that's the reason we don't even send children away from the classroom, even for the lunch. You keep it inside the classroom and you make them to sit and eat. So one of my students is coming out with a beautiful drawing, a child sitting in a closet, where reading a book, everything goes, eat, and do all the stuff in the same room. So that's the education. So thank you. So this is what I wanted to share in this August gathering. Digital skill, which is very important for the future, because every time everything is being digitalized. So you can see the percentage. And you can get this presentation from Google, from Oxford Economics, HR perspective from 2021, global talent. Agile thinking, these are the five parameters they are talking about. And 54.8%, it comes under the category of prepare for the multiple scenario. This is very important because you are moving into a global village. Now the whole village has become global. Interpersonal communication, that's where the conflict already much talked about. And the most important thing is global operating skill. Please allow our children to take up at least 2 months of break from all your nonsense and let them enjoy the world. Thank you very much for the time.